So in the videos that I've been making using these Python examples, I've been using Python 2. I've been using Python 2, which is kind of the standard version of Python that most implementations are in at the time of making this video. But there is also a Python 3. There is also a Python 3, which is kind of the state-of-the-art version of Python. Or I guess you could say it's the newest version of Python. But it's not backwards compatible. When I say backwards compatible, it means that if you're running Python 3, it will not necessarily be able to interpret everything that is written in Python 2. So that's what we mean by backwards compatibility. You can't take a program that was written in Python 2. So let's take a program. That's the program right there. And let's say it runs fine in Python 2. If you take that same program and try to run it in a Python 3 interpreter, it's not going to work. So this is not backwards compatible. Backwards compatible. If this did work, then Python 3 would be backwards compatible. And the whole reason, well, you know, this is actually a nice understanding of what even backwards compatibility means. But the whole point of making this video is the program that I ran in the last video will work in Python 2. It will work in Python 2, but it will not work in Python 3. And the reason why it doesn't work in Python 3 is that Python 3 has a different version of this input function. Over here. In Python 2, if you use the input function just like I used it, and I put a message here for the user of what to input, and when the user inputs something, it'll be returned to the program fully evaluated. So in this case, if the user enters a number, I get the number as a number. So I literally get the evaluated expression. So like we saw in the last few examples, if the user puts in a 4, then the number 4 will be put in the variable number. If the user inputs literally 3 plus 4, then the number 7 will be put into the variable number. In Python 3, the input function does something slightly different. And it's enough to break this program if you were to try to run it in Python 3. In Python 3, the input function doesn't return an evaluated expression. It returns a string. And this isn't a word you're going to hear a lot of in computer science, and I'll explain it in multiple videos. But it returns a string of what the user input. User inputted. And you're saying, Sal, what is a string? And this is actually a good introduction. A string is a string of characters. So to maybe make the difference, if the user inputs right over here, so this is coming from the user. If the user inputs in the Python 2 version 2 times 6, then what will be stored in the variable number will be the 2 times the 6. So it will be 12. It'll actually be evaluated. In Python 3, if we just did this, and the user inputted 2 times 6, so once again, the user inputs 2 times 6, then what's stored in the variable number, what's returned from this function right over here, is not going to be 2 times 6 evaluated. It is going to be a string of characters that says 2 times 6. So this is this string, and string is really, you can just view it as a string of characters. You can kind of view it as some text that's not actually interpreted in any way. So it'll actually return that string of characters, and then you'd have that string of characters put here in number, and then the function here range would break down, because like I'm trying to take the range of like a word, not like a number here. So that's why it would break in Python 3. So if you want that original function to work in Python 3, what you have to do is put an, so instead of just calling input like this, you have to, and I'll write it below this, you would have to write eval, and then write input, and then in quotes, all of the stuff that I wrote up here, colons, close quote, close parentheses, and then close the eval parentheses right over there. And what eval does is it can take a string of characters. It can take some text like this, and it'll evaluate it. So what happens is that in Python 3, you'll get this string, and then when you eval it, so then you would do an eval on this. So you do an eval on this. So you're doing an eval on the input. The user puts some input, so then you're doing an eval on what the user inputted, and then this will return, and then this will return 12. So in Python 2, the input function kind of does it all for you. Python 3, it returns a string, and then you have to evaluate the string to get 12. So if you try to do this on Python 3 and it broke, that is the reason why. You got to put an eval around it.